This here is the Intel NUC 11, a budget mini PC we found on AliExpress at a fairly reasonable price. In today's video, we'll see what this is capable of, and unbox the mystery of the
N6005.
Welcome to Team Pandori.
Subscribble.
So this here is what arrived. The Intel NUC 11. This series of mini PCs are supposed to be of high quality, and hopefully we'll experience some of this magic today. Inside the box we get the mini PC, and it seems very sturdy. We get three manuals, a European power cord to add to our Japanese one, a bag of screws for mounting, and a power adapter. This one here outputs at 19 volts, 3.42 amps, with a maximum of just under 65 watts. We also have an Intel sticker. So this uses the Intel Pentium Silver N6005, a CPU seldomly seen in mini PCs. This processor has 4 cores, 4 threads, in line with the others in this price range, like the N100 and the N95. However, where this differs is its lower CPU clock speed and many more cores on the GPU. From the information on the sales page, we can see it uses DDR4 memory. For the storage, it comes with a PCIe 3 NVMe, and we have 2 video outputs, which should be capable of 4K at 60Hz. Some of the standards here are of last gen, but we feel there are some features of this box that stand out from the rest, like those header pins at the front of the case. You can purchase this mini PC from AliExpress, and there are a few configurations you can choose from. We'll have a few affiliate links down below if you want to check them out and help out the channel. It comes with a layer of plastic you can take off if you want, but outside that, this seems very sturdy. A solid brick of a mini PC weighing in at 547 grams. There's nothing really that stands out here, so our guess is that this mini PC is mainly to be sold for offices. Let's have a look around. On the front we have a small power switch, two USB 3.2 Gen 1s, the front header pins, shielded by a piece of rubber, and these look like the classic motherboard pins. We should be able to wire LEDs or switches to these. Next to that we have a 3.5mm microphone jack, and one more for headphones or audio. On the right we have holes for cooling. Oh, and what's this? Kensington!
Kensington!
That's right. On the back we have an exhaust vent, a small mounting hole for cable management, then we have DisplayPort 1.4, 1GB Ethernet LAN, two USB 2.0s, two USB 3.2 Gen 2s, HDMI 2.0B, and a DC input jack for power. On the other side we've got some more holes if you want to grate some cheese, and underneath is packed full of stickers and mounting options. The rubber feet aren't really to aid cooling, but just to stop it slipping around. And as mentioned with the mounts, you could use tie wrap to attach this to something, or even hook it onto the wall with a couple of screws. When turning it on for the first time, we didn't get a setup screen. It was booted straight into Windows already logged in. There were no viruses, but Malwarebytes detected that the remnants of a hacking tool was present, which aids in obtaining a dodgy version of Windows. If they did this or not is up for debate, but updating is possible, and if you're in this situation, reinstalling or using Linux is recommended. As for what this computer can do, usual office tasks, no problems whatsoever. Performance is similar to that of budget mini PCs, so internet shopping and even 4K YouTube is possible, and it works pretty smoothly. As for productivity, 2D art software, and programming for websites and things like that are on the table, making it ideal as a small computer for a student. Lagmon reports low latency, so this will be good for tracking music, but having 4 cores and 4 threads probably won't be enough for large projects with multiple VSDs running. Crystalmark gives good results due to a fairly fast NVMe stick.
Hard like my stick.
We have interesting scores from Geekbench, and comparing it to the competition, the CPU is lackluster, but it has fairly high GPU scores. It'd be interesting to see how this fares in games. In TimeSpy, the NUC takes a lead on the Beelink N95 and the Melee N100, but everything else leaves it standing. As for the Wi-Fi, we've got a fairly decent signal, but the Intel 9462 is an older Wi-Fi 5 chip with a slowish top speed. We're going to throw in one more benchmark, which will show us exactly where this sits in comparison to the other Intel budget mini PCs. The N6005 gives us a total of just over 6,700 frames. In a video roundup last year, we tested out a few others in a similar price range, and the 6005 performs similar to the 5105. But there may be something we can do to speed it up. It opens up easily enough, and there's what's inside. We have one stick of silicon power DDR4 3200 memory in one of the two slots. Storage is an Acer N3500, and this one's a PCIe 3x4 TLC. Here's the Intel Wi-Fi and Bluetooth if you want to change it out. What we're going to do is change the memory for a dual core DDR4 setup to see if we can squeeze out any more performance. And indeed, there is a noticeable boost. Well, this is mainly when gaming. And if we check out benchmarks again, the difference is quite minimal, especially when it comes to the CPU. And in this dual channel setup,
let's go fishing. As soon as you get a bit further in, yeah, we are hitting 30 FPS at 720p. Yeah, much more playable. Oops. And for a game that really likes to trip up minis, Super Woden GP2. Bit low, but that's probably because this game is running on the Unity engine. Let's see if we can flick it down to 720p. Yeah, much better. Still not hitting, well, it is hitting 60, but eh, it works.
Hello, trees. Hi, trees.
What?
Sounds like a good idea. If you say so. Bottom is missing.
But otherwise, it's looking pretty decent, like over 50 FPS. It's not the best, but it's definitely playable on the system. Oh, everyone's ripped on this game.
Why? I want to watch the soldiers.
Run! Run for your life!
Yarl, what is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Legends don't burn out.
It's playing pretty well, probably due to the high amount of memory.
Probably best if we split up. Good luck.
Yeah.
I couldn't have made it.
No, don't kick me. No.
Bye.
Uh-oh. Ooh. Don't know how to play this game at all. Initial jump a bit sketchy, as it always is, especially on such a low-powered system. 30 FPS. Let's see how we are when we touch down. 10. Sorry.
So, it's not the best for gaming, is it? That's right. Let's get into the BIOS. And as you can see here, this chipset is limited to 2933MHz on the memory. We do have a variety of options, but nothing more than the basics. And the only thing that stands out is the Intel branding. We can alter fan profiles and enable secure boot if you want to play Valorant, but I'd rather boot up from an SSD or punch myself in the net. Either way, here's Badassera Linux. This is a great front end for a lot of emulation needs, and both Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are working great in Badassera 40 and 41. As you can see, we can connect to our Bluetooth controller, as well as our Wi-Fi router, which is called Monkey Balls. This mini PC can emulate arcade games like Sega Naomi, and also heavier titles like Tekken and Killer Instinct 2. It's on PSP at 4x resolution. And PlayStation 2 at 1.5x resolution. When it comes down to it, emulation performance is very similar to the N5105, making it better than a Pi 4, but nowhere near as fast as any of the Ryzen competition, or even the N100 that belongs in the same bracket. At idle, the CPU sits at around 38 degrees Celsius and is extremely quiet. and it pulls around 8 watts from the wall. After putting a 100% load on CPU and GPU, temps raise to the lower 60s, and it continues to be a very quiet unit. And this uses 28 watts. So what about these little pins at the front? Well, as I mentioned earlier, they're the same as those found on motherboards, allowing us to add LEDs or switches for reset and power. We picked this one up from AliExpress for around $3, and if we check the connectors, they're clearly labelled as to where each one should go. And as this mini PC is pretty good for emulation, let's hook it up to our arcade cab. And with the mini PC tucked away, all we need is the power button, and we've got a nice arcade setup. It's about time for the pros and the cons. The Nutbox 11 has a robust design, and it stays quiet and cool. It came with reliable storage and memory, and features such as two memory slots, as well as front pins, are rare at this price point. As for the cons, we do have concern about this version of Windows. The website is very unclear with its specs, and the aging tech is becoming quickly irrelevant, especially when you find the competition at around the $150 price point. If you can find one of these for cheap, it might be worth it if you intend to use it as an office PC or an emulation hub. But if you want something for gaming, we recommend checking out a Ryzen Mini PC, such as the K8 Plus. We do like the NUC 11 for what it is, but if it was just a little bit cheaper and used at least an N100, what the f- Summary.
Mini machine with zero style, black brick with a four-core smile, quite hard, no noise to hide, mounting options, windows glide.
If you want to pass by and have a chinwag, we have Discord, and if you want to support us, we have Patreon, and also a few more videos on our channel.
Do you need to borrow my Spot the Dog books?
No, I don't, but maybe later. This has been Amy Chicken of Team Pandori. I'll catch you on the next one. Ta-ra!